Hello everybody, Andrea here with Dental El Mobile Hygiene. So I want to talk to you guys about what if a dentist has told you that your child has a cavity or many cavities and their best option is to get sleep sedation. So sleep dentistry, moderate sedation, however they called it, but they want to put your child to sleep to get their cavities fixed. So you do have other options. I'm not saying that the dentist is wrong, because absolutely not. But let me tell you about a couple things that I look for in your child to really see what type of cavities they have. And we might have a very strict oral hygiene routine at home. I might suggest I come see your child once a month to apply a special liquid to their teeth to prevent their cavities from getting worse. But that's so much better than sedating your child and having to pay $5,000, right? If it's not needed. So let me show you guys a couple pictures, okay? I'm just going to share my screen here. So I want to show you a couple things. So first thing is, what I first look for is which teeth have cavities and when they're going to lose their teeth. So this is a great chart. You can find this online if you type in dental charting for kids, dental eruption for kids. It shows when these teeth will come through the mouth and when they will lose those teeth. Really pay attention to when they're going to lose those teeth and which tooth or teeth have cavities in them. If they're going to lose that tooth in 2 months, you don't need to go through sedation. I'm not saying to leave the cavity alone. I would still come to your house because I'm a mobile dental hygienist. I would apply a liquid called silver diamine fluoride. It takes 2 seconds. That will stop that cavity from getting worse. If it's going to fall out in 2 months, that's all that's needed. You do not need to go to the dentist, have them drill out the cavity and fill the tooth if they're just going to lose it soon anyway. But if they're going to lose that tooth in 1 year's time, let's say, the option might be best to go to the dentist to have that cavity fixed, but it does depend on other things. I might suggest a high strength fluoride toothpaste at home. I might suggest me coming in to apply that same liquid every month to kill that cavity before it gets worse. And as long as your child's not in pain, we can do that for the full year. So they never have to get sleep sedation or have a traumatizing experience. But it does depend on a couple things. So let me show you a couple more pictures. So let's say your child's cavities. Now look at your child now, if you're the one who has the child with cavities. I don't know if you guys can see this on camera here or on my YouTube video, but you see this little yellow spot? Well, it's not little, but it's moderate. That is a cavity, but that's not as severe as, let's say, these cavities, okay? These black areas that have been eating away at the teeth for a while. It looks like they've even chipped a tooth because of such a big cavity. But then what about, where's that other picture I wanted to show you? Oh, maybe I got rid of it somehow. Sorry, guys, I did have another one. But so it does depend on the different kinds of cavities. Do they look like this, or are they more advanced where they look like this? So if I see your child and things do look like this, it still depends on when they're going to lose those teeth. I can still apply that silver diamine fluoride liquid to kill any of those active bacterial cavities. I can do that. I would definitely suggest a high strength fluoride and xylitol toothpaste together to really protect the other teeth from getting cavities, but to also prevent these cavities from getting bigger after I apply that special anti-cavity liquid that can only be applied by a dental professional. With something like this, I might have to come in to see your child every 2 weeks, every month to apply that anti-cavity liquid, the silver diamine fluoride, and to make sure you guys are helping your child brush well with a high strength fluoride toothpaste with xylitol, limiting as much sugar as possible, drinking a lot of water. But again, it depends. Let's say you're not able to brush their teeth well. Let's say you don't have time for me to come every month or every 2 weeks in extreme cavities to apply the liquid, then I will say the cavities are going to get worse. You need to have those fixed by a dentist ASAP or it's going to cause pain. Cavities, you guys, are a dental disease in the mouth. It's a disease that's festering literally in the mouth. They will get worse. But if they're going to lose those teeth, even these extreme ones, you know, I don't know how old this patient is, of course, but if they're going to lose those teeth in 2 months, then why not save a lot of money? Have me apply that silver diamine fluoride liquid, a fluoride varnish, use the right toothpaste, and that's fine. if it's going to take a year to lose those teeth and you don't really want to brush better, you can't limit the sugar for your child, then I will say something different. It really depends on the parents. It depends on the child. What I like about this toothpaste, you guys, this is the fluoride toothpaste that I give to my patients quite often. Sorry if it takes a while to focus there. It's a fluoride and xylitol toothpaste. Okay, it doesn't want to focus. You can see like xylitol and fluoride here, but it's really blurry. Sorry, guys. Anyway, what I like about this toothpaste is it's clear and it doesn't taste like anything. So even if your child has a favorite toothpaste, which most of them do, give them that toothpaste, but put this toothpaste over top of it so they're getting the benefits of both. They need a high strength fluoride and xylitol toothpaste with decay, okay? So if you have gone to the dentist and they're suggesting sedation, you do have other options. I would love to have a look at your child in person and really determine what's going on. I might say to you, you know what? It is best to have sedation done. Or I might say to you, you know what? We can really do something strict here. I'm gonna see you every month for the next 6 months, but we can prevent those cavities from getting worse. We can prevent that child from not having pain. And there you go. They'll lose those teeth because sleep sedation is about $5,000, depending on the case. It is traumatic, you guys, for parents and children. So if you don't have to go through that, that's like my mission in life. It really is to avoid sleep sedation in children, because I find these days, and I'm being honest with you, I don't even know if I should say this, but a lot of dentists, that's what they go to. When they see a child has decay, they don't ask you questions of, well, are you brushing? They just assume you're not brushing. They don't ask questions like, what toothpaste do you use? Well, here, try another one. They don't say, we're going to be seeing you every month from now on. Yeah, I know you don't want to see us, but this will prevent further decay. They probably don't do that, do they? What they do is they say, your child needs sleep sedation. Here's a paperwork. You know, here's the paperwork of $1 million that you're going to have to spend. I'll see you in 3 months. So I try to avoid that. So please comment below with any questions. I'm so happy to help, and I'll talk to you guys in the next video.